Hi everybody, today is March 8th, 2013. This is not good. UN peacekeepers pull out of Syria-Israeli DMZ as civil war edges closer. Eight peacekeepers who were escorted into Israel by the IDF are part of the same battalion as 21 UN troops who were captured by Syria rebels on Wednesday. In a stark illustration of how the Syrian civil war has the potential to end decades of calm in its neighbors as well. Eight United Nations peacekeepers who were working in the demilitarized zone between Israel and Syria abandoned their post today, saying they feared for their lives. Hazaret reports that eight soldiers are in the same battalion as the 21 Filipino peacekeepers who were captured by Syrian rebels Wednesday. The captured UN peacekeepers were taken near the Syrian town of Jemela, less than a mile from the border and the site of fierce fighting between regime and rebel troops. The rebels say they are holding the peacekeepers until Syrian army troops leave the area around Jemela. The Israeli Defense Forces, IDF, have brought the eight who left their post today into Israel in coordination with the UN Disengagement Force, UNDOF, command. The UN has monitored the Golan Heights ceasefire line between Israel and Syria since 1974. When a demilitarized zone was formed between Israel and Syria following the 1973 war. The border has been consistently quiet in the almost four decades since the war's conclusion. The rebels holding the peacekeepers said today that no talks are underway to free the captives, and that they would not be released anytime soon. Reuters reports in a video released yesterday, the peacekeepers said they were being treated well. Now in an updated article, I think this is, it says, UN expects to free hostages in Syria on Saturday, but it's already Saturday their time and there's been no word that they have been freed. UN officials say they have completed arrangements for the release of 21 Philippine peacekeepers held in the Golan Heights by Syrian rebels, and the handover is expected to take place Saturday. A UN convoy tried to pick up the peacekeepers late Friday, but was forced to turn back by shelling and airstrikes carried out by the Syrian government forces. Subsequently, UN officials said arrangements were made with all parties for the hostages' release, but due to the late hour, it was considered unsafe to continue the operation. UN authorities said they hoped to complete the rescue mission and reach the Philippine peacekeepers' troops on Saturday. The initial attempt to retrieve the hostages Friday ended when UN vehicles had to retreat under fire after reaching Jemela village, where the hostages had been held. UN peacekeeping chief briefed Security Council members in New York Friday and confirmed to reporters that Syrian forces shelled and bombed Jemela. But the Syrian UN ambassador, also in New York, refuted claims that troops are bombing Jemela, telling reporters that they are targeting the suburbs of the villages where armed groups are concentrated. The peacekeepers from the Philippines are part of a 1,000-plus force that patrols a zone between Israel and Syria in the Golan Heights. They were detained Wednesday by Syrian rebels who have identified themselves as the Martyrs of Yamok, and I'm probably pronouncing that wrong. UN officials have been negotiating their release with rebel commanders who are demanding that Syria government troops leave the area. President Bashar Assad has not commented on the incident. A spokesman for the Martyrs of Yarmouk Brigade holding the peacekeepers said that they failed in their responsibility to keep heavy weapons out of the area, as mandated by the 1974 agreement. A limited number of tanks and troops are permitted within the 13 miles of the disengagement line, Reuters reports. Tassil said that the Syrian army warplanes were bombing the rebels within a half of a mile. The UN reported in December that both the army and the rebels had violated the agreement and entered the demilitarized area, and the army had affected adversely UNDOF operations. Errant Syrian shelling has landed in Israeli territory multiple times in the past year. In the report, the UN warned that recent incidents across the ceasefire line have shown the potential for escalation of tensions between Israel and the Syrian Arab Republic and jeopardizes the ceasefire between the two countries. So we could see Damascus laid to rubble as prophesied. This could be the tipping point for that. We'll just have to watch. This is not good. All right, bookmark my site. I'll keep everyone up to date. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.